Hi there, and welcome to another tutorial by ColorScream. Today we are going to learn basic expressions in After Effects. When you want to create complex animations, but would like to avoid creating hundreds of keyframes by hand, try using expressions. An expression is a little piece of software that evaluates to a single value for a single layer property at a specific point in time. The expression language is based on the standard JavaScript language, but you do need to know JavaScript to use expressions. You can create expressions by using the pickwhip or by copying simple examples and modifying them to suit your needs. Let's move to After Effects. We can access expressions in two ways. One is by clicking on the property, in our case this is the rotation property, and selecting animation and add expression. The second is to simply alt-click on the stopwatch next to the rotation property. Using the arrow next to the pickwhip, you gain access to all expressions available in After Effects. In our case, we use key time. Essentially, the time expression returns a number value related to our current position in the timeline. For example, if you were at 45 seconds, the time expression would return a value of 45 and the square will be slanted by 45 degrees. Let's go to our clock composition. Usually, what we would do is to animate the clock's hands with keyframes. We would take the seconds hand and rotate it by 360 degrees in 1 minute. You will have to do the same for the minutes and hour hands. To avoid using keyframes, we will use some expressions. Let's start with the easiest one, the seconds hand. Select the layer, press R for rotation, alt-click on the stopwatch next to the rotation property, and enter the following expression. Time times 6 and semicolon. The hand moves 6 degrees every second, so we have to multiply the time value by 6. But right now the hand is being smoothly animated. Let's make it more realistic. As you can see, seconds are divided into 25 frames, so one frame is 0.04 seconds. Add math.floor to the expression. The math.floor function in JavaScript is used to round off the number passed as parameter to its nearest integer in downward direction towards the lesser value. So we've learned about the time method, which represents the composition time in seconds at which the expression is being evaluated. And we've learned about the math.floor, which is one of the mathematical round functions next to math.round and math.seal. Now let's proceed to the minutes hands. Let's close this property. Let's select the minutes layer. Press R for rotation and alt-click on the stopwatch. Type in seconds equals, and with the cursor in this place, take the pickwhip and drag it onto the rotation property of our seconds hand layer. Terminate the line with a semicolon. In After Effects, a variable can be thought of as a container that holds a value. To create a variable, we simply type the variable name and use the equal sign. After the equal sign comes the value that should be stored in the variable. In our case, we use the pickwhip to link the variable with the slider value. Every variable has to be terminated with a semicolon. Variables are used to store values that can be reused later. They also keep the code clean and more readable. Since every minute contains 60 seconds, we have to divide the seconds by 60 and end this line with a semicolon. Let's collapse the rotation property. Now let's move to the hour hand expression. Press R for rotation, alt-click on the stopwatch, and type in the following code. Minutes equals, and with the cursor in this position, drag the pickwhip to the rotation of the minutes layer. Terminate the layer with a semicolon. In the second line, enter the following code. Minutes divided by 12, semicolon. This is how the clock looks like now. Now let's move towards automating the expressions. For this, we'll create an adjustment layer, which we will name controller. From the effects panel, we look for slider control and drag it onto the controller layer. We will rename this controller to speed factor. We control click on the slider itself, edit value, and we enter the following values. Slider range minus 100 to 100 and the value is 1. Now open our seconds rotation property, make some plays here, and in the first line write the following code: speed factor equals, drag the pick whip to the slider itself. Terminate the line with a semicolon. Now we have to multiply the output by our speed factor. As you can see right now, the animation plays at the normal speed rate. And if we raise up the speed factor, it plays much faster. You can even stop time or reverse it. What we did here is now we are able to control the speed of time passing by on our clock using keyframes. Everything is controlled using our controller layer. You can set the time flow to real time by setting the value to 1. Let's move on with more complex stuff. What about setting the start time? Add 3 new slider controls to our controller layer. Rename them to second start, minute start, hour start. Control click on their sliders and select edit value. For minute, the slider range is from 0 to 59. For minutes, the slider range is also from 0 to 59. And for hours, the range is from 0 to 11. Open the seconds rotation expression and add the following code to it. Start equals math.floor. And inside the parentheses, we have to insert the code from the second slider. We also have to multiply the value by 6. In the end, we have to add the value to the output. Let's move on to minutes. Open the expressions. Create a new variable called start equals math.floor parentheses. Inside parentheses, we have to insert the value from the minute slider and multiply this value by 6. Again, we have to add the value to the output. This expression will also be inserted into hours rotation. Again, create a new variable called start equals math.floor. Drag the slider value and multiply this value by 30. As previously, add the start value to the output. Right now you can select your desired start time. Let's test this out. 45 seconds. As you can see, the minutes hands also move accordingly. Let's adjust the minute time by, I don't know, 15. And set the hours like for 5. Let's test if the clock still works. And apparently it does. As you could see in this tutorial, expression can help you save a ton of time. I leave you now to digest the knowledge and let you play around. The expressions can be found in the description. I hope you've enjoyed this tutorial, and if you have any comments or questions, please do not hesitate to leave them in the comment section. If you've found this video useful, please subscribe to my channel and hit the thumbs up button. Thank you very much for watching, and we'll see us again in the next video. Have a great day!